I'm here at the Jerusalem Bird Observatory next to the Knesset, the Israeli parliament. We learn here about the concept of biological species, the basic taxonomic unit. Two organisms belong to the same species if they can sire fertile offspring. This is a deceptively simple definition. However, you will soon realize that life is more complex. When I was about 12 years old, I was a bird watcher together with Amir Balagban, who together with Gideon Perlman established the Bird Observatory here. The differences between us was and remained that Amir knew how to identify birds, while I often failed to do so. The reason I failed is that many bird species look very, very similar, at least in my eyes. Often the differences between males and females of the same species are more pronounced than the differences between species. When bird watching, you often see the bird only for a few seconds on a faraway branch. I asked Amir to tell us about this special place and the fascinating work they are doing here.
Good morning, welcome to the Jerusalem Bird Observatory. This is a community urban wildlife site situated right by the parliament in Capitol Hill in the center of Jerusalem. Our observatory aims to protect a very special birding site and also monitor the movement of passerines through Jerusalem. You can see that twice a year birds migrate through Israel, and the urban areas are very important for migratory birds, especially the parklands and the open habitats that we have here. With a very simple technique, we ring the birds with the aluminium rings. We take biometrics, different measurements that enable us to understand the condition of the birds. We also have a microgeographic system that shows us where the birds are staying and how they're using the site. We are also conducting some research, trying to figure out where the birds are changing the feathers, and with the different isotopes that make up the feather, understand where this is happening in Africa.
In many cases, we can't really know whether different populations belong to the same species. Look, for example, at these giraffes that we observed in Kidepo in Uganda. And these here we observed in South Luanga in Zambia. And these in Etosha in Namibia. Until lately, they were all considered to belong to the same species. 2 years ago, a paper based on genomic sequencing was published, claiming that they comprise three different species. Giraffes are now confined mainly to reserves and live therefore in isolated populations, so we don't know if they can interbreed in nature. If it is difficult to establish the species of living organism, this is considerably harder for fossils. We will walk now over to the nearby dog park, where we can watch different dogs. Dogs have a huge variability in size, form, color and character. And yet they all belong to the same species and can interbreed. Admittedly, this variability is due to human selection. However, all these differences evolved without reproductive barrier. Indeed, a big size difference could prevent crossbreeding. However, as both big and small dogs can breed with intermediate ones, they are all considered a single species. You might get the impression that species identification is a theoretical issue. However, in fact, it is of great importance to the animals themselves. To breed successfully, animals must make sure that they mate with an individual of the same species. If they mate by mistake with a different one, all of their reproductive effort and gametes go to waste. There are therefore very efficient mechanisms to enable animals to identify their species. These are based on smell, sight and sound. We will therefore finish this video by observing different species of bee-eater. Each species has a very distinct color pattern. It is possible that this specific plumage color serves for species identification, though we can't be sure. We do, however, know that these magnificent birds have a superb sense of vision that enables them to catch bees and other insects in mid-air. I assume that I confused you a bit, but this is okay, and even on purpose. I wanted to show you that even something as apparently simple as a species can be rather complex and requires some thought.